I ain't got no time for no games. Tell me what you like, but it's never gonna change. So you do what you wanna do, and I'm not going home with you, home with you.
Her single, Home With You, is racing up the charts. Welcome singer Madison Bieber. Hello, good
Hi.
To see you.
That's so cool, thank you.
You look so beautiful.
Thank you, so do you.
So good to talk to you. Okay, so before we get to your music, I was actually reading this and I thought this was fascinating. You've been living in LA since you were 16, right, without any family?
Well, okay, so I moved here when I was 14, and my mom and my brother moved out here as well. And then when I turned 18, my mom, my brother's only 15.
Right.
So he still, you know, him getting homeschooled wasn't as easy as me getting homeschooled.
Right.
So she decided to move him back to New York, where all of his friends are and stuff, because there wasn't really a need for him to be out here because he's not pursuing music or anything. So she moved back to New York with him when I turned 18, but it's since I was 16, it's kind of been like them back and forth by Coastal and me here, kind of alone.
Do you take advantage of that? Like, do you eat Pop-Tarts all day?
Yeah, pretty much, honestly, yeah.
Go to bed when
like,
you
want. Like, huge no-turkey.
You would do.
I would do that. I would do that. I'd eat ding-dongs, too, but like, but I mean, like, do you have a curfew? Do you make a curfew? Anything?
I mean, I live alone. Now I, like, have my own apartment
right.
and stuff, but my parents have always been super cool with me. I've been working since I was 12,
right.
so it's kind of like they let me be a kid when I want to be
right.
and when I can be. It's kind of rare that I get to actually be a kid these days. But yeah, I mean, I guess I don't really have a curfew. I could walk in at 3 in the morning and be, yeah, I'm like, it's all good. I don't have anyone to yell at me.
Right. So I thought this was so cool. So you started out kind of doing like cover songs on YouTube, and then Justin Bieber saw one and retweeted it out, right? And it got like 25 million views or something, and
wow.
is that how this all kind of started?
Yeah, that's how it kickstarted. I've told the story a bunch of times, and it kind of every time I tell it, it still feels super surreal to me. It's just, I was 12 years old. I had gotten my braces off a week before, and I used to record at this place in Long Island called the Loft Sound Studio, which literally was a loft. It was a closet mm-hmm. above a dance studio. That's what it was.
Right.
And I recorded a YouTube video in there, and it was called a Bruno Mars mashup. And it was basically all of Bruno Mars's songs in one song.
Right.
And I wrote it on my phone. I had all the lyrics down. And in the video, I'm actually reading the lyrics off of my phone,
wow.
which if I was trying to get discovered, I probably would have done a little bit more professionally. And I did that. And then about a week later, I did an At Last cover by Etta James.
Right.
And that was the one that Justin had tweeted out. And he actually tweeted out 3 of my YouTube videos, which was insane.
Oh my God, I just got goosebumps.
It was insane. I mean, as a 12-year-old girl who would have died for Justin
right.
Bieber.
Yes.
I was,
right.
Yeah,
yes.
I was through the roof. I used to wear like purple lipstick on his birthday. So it was pretty crazy.
Oh
yeah, it was really, really crazy.
No, Home With You is a hit, but it wasn't necessarily supposed to be the first single, right?
Yeah. Right. When I put my EP out, I kind of let the fans decide what was going to be the single. I was like, let's just put it out, and whatever song gets the most streams within the first 2 weeks, mm-hmm. we'll decide that's the single. And it was hard because during the first 2 weeks, when there's so many people listening to it in that time frame, it's like, okay, well, all of them have kind of the same amount of streams. So it was literally just 1,000 or 2,000 to make
right.
the difference.
Right.
And Home With You was the one that people were more drawn to, and I decided to go with that one.
So is that then when you make the video after?
I didn't make the video until it started gaining a lot of traction, actually,
okay.
because it's expensive to make videos,
yeah.
and I'm such a creative person in the sense of, like, I wrote the treatment with the director, I helped direct the video, I edited a lot of the video myself, so it's like, for me to put that much effort into it, I really want to make sure the fans,
yeah.
it's worth it for them. So once it started gaining traction and radio started picking it up a little bit, we decided to make the video.
I have to ask you, it looked like you have a tattoo on the inside of your, could you show us?
Is it Justin Bieber?
What does it say?
It says Justin Bieber. It says honey.
Honey.
Honey. Isn't that cute?
That didn't
kinda
hurt
ridiculous.
Or anything.
It hurt really bad.
Yeah. Why like, honey?
I actually don't even know. It was when that Kanye West song was out where he goes, uh-huh, honey, and I would listen to it all the time with my friends. And then I wanted a tattoo for so long, but my grandmother would probably disown me if she knew I got a tattoo.
Does she know you have it?
She knows I have that one, but since it's hidden, she's fine
okay.
with it. Yeah, she's
Nana's
okay.
Nana's okay with that.
She's okay with it.
Okay.
Because it's supposed to go away after a few years.
Oh.
It hasn't gone away, but it's supposed to, so we'll see.
Unbelievable. So your debut EP, As She Pleases, has over 340 million streams.
Yeah.
Do you think now, especially given your background, that to be a musician, you have to have an insane social media presence also?
I do in a sense, and I also don't. There's so many artists that I love and I think are incredible that have 10,000 followers,
mm-hmm.
not even on social media, which now for an artist is not a lot. And I mean, I think it obviously helps because I feel like my supporters get an outlet where they could see me daily and they could,
right.
you know, we could interact. But I also think it hurts you in some ways because it's like, music is just a way to express yourself, and I feel like when people feel like they know you so much, it's hard for them to connect with the music. Oh, I don't really know how to explain, you know what I'm saying? It's like, it's when...
Well, I think it's like when actors, same thing, is you get to know them so well
it's hard to believe them
when they step into another. I get your point.
Yeah, I feel like 10, 15 years ago, musicians were musicians, and that was it. Nowadays, my fans know what kind of food to order me if I went to a restaurant and what kind of toothpaste I use. So it's like,
right, it takes the mystery out of it.
Exactly. It's kind of just, it's a little harder to make it believable.
It's so good to see you. Congratulations on all your success. For being 19 years old, you have so much poise
Thank
and presence.
You. I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
And tattoos and all that. So good to see you.
Thank you.
Madison's new EP, As She Pleases, is out and available right now. Good to see
you, Madison.
Thank you guys so
good
much.
Luck to you.
Thank you.